I believe strongly, strongly in knowledge. I like knowledge. That is why I try not to be too emotional when I'm doing this ministry work. The way we are gathered here now, let me tell you, every week, there is no week that we pass in this world we are in that a special prayer will not be on this mountain outside Wednesday. By next week now, I say, God, whose special case do you want to handle? Say, okay, do this, and we announce it. That day, we gather here. Every week, there must be mass here for different cases, for different intentions, for different problems. Somebody here must carry. Because God is working, even as you are sitting down since morning, since 6 o'clock, you took your bath, you came down here, you are waiting. When I came, I entered the chapel there. I said, God revealed to me many, many years which I've used to handle this case. In Exodus chapter 23, verse 25 and 26. Exodus chapter 23, from verse 25, 26. The Bible says, you must serve only the Lord your God with food and water, and I will make you healthy. There will be no miscarriages or infertility among your people, and I will give you long, full lives. Somebody say, I receive.
I receive.
Believe and accept that this word is for you.
Amen.
Forget about what has happened yesterday, last year, 5 years, the complications around you. Here is a special word that God is giving to you today, that He has invited you for this feast. There will be no miscarriages.
Amen.
For those of you having miscarriages, it is over. No more miscarriages. I say no more miscarriages,
yeah,
or barrenness,
yeah,
or infertility,
yeah,
among you again.
Yeah.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 14 says, you will be blessed above all the nations of the earth. None of your men or women will be childless.
Yeah.
Now can you please connect your faith net to my faith? As I declare, all of you that have come for this program, you will surely bear your own children. God bless them and told them, multiply, fill the earth, and subdue it. Be fruitful. Today, many people are barren, many are not fruitful, many people are in sorrow, hatred and divorce, pain, and the devil is taking advantage of this inability to have children to deal with so many people. If you know what, you know yourself, you know what you may have passed through, but in the course of my ministry, when I say this ministry that God has given, even though I'm still young, it started very early. It started with my ordination, so I have a lot of experiences, a lot. Beyond what people think I know. Even my bishop may not know the kind of experiences I have gotten in this kind of ministry. Because sometimes it is not easy to say all of them. But a lot of children of God have suffered so much because of barrenness. Children of God have gone to where they are not supposed to go. Many children of God, they have drank what they are not supposed to drink. Many children of God, they have slept where they are not supposed to sleep. Many children of God have tied what they are not supposed to tie on their body. Sometimes their mother-in-law will force them. And for them to keep the family going, they obey the mother-in-law. Auntie, their husband's sister will drag them to where they don't even know about. They will be asked to sleep here, eat here, do this, and they have done all kinds of things. So many great men of God that are doing all this work for their warriors, they defy me. So if they give, why do they not get it? That is why it is good for you to be careful. Be very careful. For the Bible says that it is the will of God to bless us with children. But when what we are experiencing in our world is becoming so difficult and deep. And I'm going to give you some revelations why a lot of people are barren. What does it mean to be barren? It means to be unproductive. The spermatozoa that is supposed to be you or your husband is lazy. I will tell you things that many of you don't know about. A few months from now, we are having the fruit of the womb campaign at Maryhill. But there we stay from Thursday till Sunday. That one will be deeper than what we are doing. So I want to quickly let you know that we can handle this case because of God. If you study the Bible, you will realize that a lot of people experience what you are experiencing. Abraham and Sarah in Genesis chapter 18, they experienced it. But God gave them a child called Isaac. In Genesis 25, Isaac and Rebekah, they experienced this, and God gave them a child. Elkanah and Anna, they experienced this, and God blessed them with child. So there are many of them. So you must believe in your God that God can do it for you. Now, what are the causes of this barrenness? Why is it that so many people are barren today? I go to crusade and I make altar call. If any of you are, the more you go to the city, the more you see them. I will give you some reasons. One is medical. The medical reasons for infertility. In that of the woman, there's what we call ovulation, which many of you know more than I do. These are the researches I did the year 2002. And it has helped many people because knowledge is power. Failure in ovulation, even when menstrual bleeding cycle appears normal, affects it. So when you are pregnant, Lord, let me. If your case has to do with irregular ovulation or no ovulation, that is a cause now. Why not direct your prayer to that? But the cause is that your ovulation is abnormal. There is failure in ovulation, even when you see your menstrual period. So every month you see blood. But before the blood comes out, you never experience normal ovulation. Have you taken time to check if you have a normal ovulatory system? And for some people, they know. Because during the time of ovulation, before the menstrual flow comes out, there are some discharges that should be coming out of a woman's body that looks like katana, that look like sperm. You don't see that at all. How can you consider that? You are supposed to know that I am in ovulation period. That means at this point in time, if I sleep with any man, I sleep with my husband, I am going to have a child. But you don't even know. From January to December, only him. And many of you mistake menstrual flow to show that you have ovulation. And that has affected so many people. And because they are ignorant of this, they have started self-medication that complicated their case. Do you know your ovulatory period? And when the time comes, that season, you don't anybody to tell you that we are in rainy season now. Because you see everywhere showing that there is rain. Your body, you must study your body, you must know your body system. Before that time they wake you, because sometimes during that your ovulatory period, when you are supposed to sleep with your husband, is when you'll be quarreling with your husband. Because the devil is a schemer. When it is time for you to get it, you and your husband will keep marriage for 5 days, 6 days. And then that time will pass. And when the time passes now, you will now settle again and begin to sleep and waste your time. For instance, after such a program now, this encounter, it put in the now. You now go back home today and tomorrow. The grace of this program is now following you. And then your ovulation period is about to come in the next 3, 4, 5 days. And you allow the devil to make you and your husband worry. If it means to lay it down, good morning, sir. Good. Why not do it? Why prove you're right? Here, prove. What are you proving? And that is how you see some people have the same case with you. God will answer them. They give their testimonies. It looks as if your own God is wicked. Your God is not wicked. It is you. You have no plan. You have no plan of how to conceive. That is number one. Number two. There's what they call inflammation of the tombs, Roman tombs, mostly due to infection. You know what there is infection causes inflammation of the tombs. So your tomb inside your belly will just be affected because of infection or zar, leading to destruction and blockage. And then sometimes you see some infection like gonorrhea. You see, some women are very comfortable with infections. And one of the major reasons of infection is lack of hygiene. Apart from STD, which is sexually transmitted disease. Maybe you slept with a man when carry one gonokanko. But majority of them has to do with hygiene. So many women are careless with their hygiene. I'm not comfortable. I, Father Dibie, when women don't allow air to go through their body, they are not. Civilizations must be followed with proper understanding. A woman will go and urinate, and some drops of urine will be on her pint. She will now wear the pint. And after wearing the pint, she will now take another pint and then stalk it again. Then after stalking it again, she will now take another trouser or skirt and then some even wear liquor again. And then stop it again. And at the end, you go fail it. And they met wicked well. There is no fresh air that is touching their sexual body. Their little skeleton bites. And they go. No. Do you know that some ladies now, even while they are still in secondary school, university, they sleep with pint, tight, and trousers? What is wrong with you? Smelling pint for that man. Some of them very dirty. And they don't care. And you don't know that that is one of the causes. That is it. Where is women? You must be very careful of infection. Your bedroom, your toilet must be clean. Because let me tell you the truth, no matter how you pray and pray, if you are living such dirty lives, it's not perfume life, it's a cosmetic life. When you don't take care of your hygiene, when your private part is always dirty, a garden for bacteria, you don't keep your private part clean because of sex. You keep your private part clean because of who you are. Not because of sex. But some women are so careless. And you know what? It started when they were very young and they have come to such age. They were very careless. They don't care. And our modern girls now, their own is worst. because they lack it. Now, the third reason why pregnancies are formed is called, I'm going to speak a long medical language terminology, but I will explain. It is called immunological factor. Immunological factor. So women develop antibodies against their husband's power. Your body will just develop something that is against your husband's power. It's an antibody. So even though when your husband releases sperm into you, your body mechanism begins to reject the spermatozoid or adjoint. If you study human being, you will fear God. Only the ear of man, if they bring that only the ear of man and then expose it for you to understand, you will fear God. If only the eye of man, if they go for eye cleaning and they show you the components of human eyes and how it operates, you will fear God. If they show you your reproductive system, how it moves, you will fear God. Do you know that when you make love with your husband, when your husband releases sperm into you, your husband releases more than 1 million spermatozoa. Do you know that in that more than 1 million, not hundreds, millions, just imagine, through the sperm into your body. Do you know that in that more than 1 million spermatozoa, only one fertilizes a woman? There's a competition among all of them. Then a body of a woman can develop antibodies that can just, that is why some people, no matter how you give them Panadol, it doesn't work for them. Their body system does not work on Panadol at all. So you know these knowledges will help you. In my life, God, any antibodies, this is a prayer point that is making my body to reject the spermatozoa of my husband, I destroy it. You know that the doctors don't know everything. I know doctors whose wives are looking for the fruit of the womb. You know, there's a doctor, my daughter, my son, in South Africa. We met the daughter. He's now in Cape Town. The husband, the wife was asking for the fruit of the womb for many years until I visited the woman. When I visited and they asked me to come and pray for them, for the woman. And I went to that. You know what? Every time I visit there, well, they must make sure all the years I visited, they take good care of me. They will bring back a day when myself and my friend will go there. There is no kind of food they will not cook in this world. They are hosting for the marriage. And then I will pray for them and we go. Luckily, she conceived. You know that when she delivered twins. You know that I had to travel. That was my first time in Cape Town. They had to say, Father, you must come and carry your babies. I left Nigeria and went to Cape Town just to carry the babies. And after that, I came back. And these people are not from Nigeria. They're not Nigerian. They're Zimbabweans, from Zimbabwe. The kind of visions pastors have collected, prophets have collected, visionaries have collected, you would have gotten at least 2 motorcycles in your compound. Another one, number D, 4, is massive fibroid. Fibroid is a new kind of disease or sickness affecting women. Sometimes fibroid will just germinate near your womb. Sometimes it will germinate inside the womb and begin to grow big. Continues to grow big. Those strange substances are not supposed to come into you. It's good to know that. Then, another reason is the malpositioning of the uterus. You know, we human beings, the way we God created us, get us to be. But sometimes there are some errors in our system. Like, for instance, a woman is put into bed that they have careless nurses around. The way they hold the picking hand, they go wasujaka. You get my point? So you now think that the child came into the world academically. And it is careless, demonic doctors and nurses. That in the course of push, they are careless. And then the way they handle that fragile baby, over the location, all their money, the child cannot say, Akapapa Jio, no. Now, there is what they call malposition. It's, if you go to the hospital, ask the doctor, please, it's my wound. You tell us where position. It's like when you want to play for benign, and then you carry for face levels when you go for stay here. I go this one. If I want to go out of this traffic now and I face here, I can't go out now. This is your own. So if there's a malpositioning of your uterus, at this point in time, it's like the uterus go safe from one and so you can come out. You not take in the position like goalkeeper when they wait for more. Anytime you make love with your husband, your body opens to receive the sperm. The sperm will be struggling to enter. But if your uterus is not positioning well, it is an error. You know that some of you, your cases are not as serious as you took it. And because you don't know, you have complicated it. You see, as I'm telling you all this, I'm really the one that have that thing on this test. Allah, because I believe in wisdom. Only in Allah can I make faith, desires, because I know the cases I handle. I have to go to doctors, I have to know why. Doctors that are Christians, I said, let me understand this case. Another reason which has affected many of you here, you don't know, is from the use of contraception. Contraception. From the use of contraceptive coils. For instance, when you were young, you don't want to carry belly, you sleep with man, you drink medicine, you get this way, you drink. And then the medicine is to prevent you from carrying belly because you don't want to make shame cash you, you don't want to make your mama beat you, your papa is very strict. While you're in the university, you have to take drugs. And we take that drug, no matter, even though it's there for your ovulatory period, no matter how you sex rich, you don't want to carry belly. Now hear me and hear me clearly. If you marry that time, you need a complete full cycle for your body to come back to normal. Because your whole blood is filled with that contraceptive drugs. That is why you cannot conceive, to prevent you from not carrying baby. And then at that particular point in time, your body system has turned upside down. Your body don't turn upside down. So no sperm will be pregnant to you, but don't take the drug. We don't turn your body upside down. Now you won't marry today. You won't go carry the next month. So you won't marry because you know the game when you don't play for many years, you will get patient. But the men of God, they're patient. And that is why your case has multiplied. So as far as you marry now, first of all, remind yourself, see, you see, I don't take plenty of job, I'm not going to carry my level. As I enter now, Lord, please help me. 1 year, 2 years, don't think you are barren. 1 year, 2 years, impossible, 3 years, you are barren. Allow your system to purify, to be purified, to flush all those chemicals within inside your blood. Imagine a young girl when enter university, first level, and the second level, you don't begin the camp. You don't begin the camp. The third level, fourth year, graduate as you go back, you take care of the Sabbath, you don't take care, then suddenly come back. The whole of your blood is filled with this drug. Your body is filled with this trouble. So you don't expect. As long as you enter man, it's bad. It will be bad. That God is inside you. It is in rare cases that despite the drugs they have taken, you can still. It's not everybody anyway, but this is what happened. And then when you now spend 1 year, 2 years, you say, no, you can't go. They may give you a series of injections. Now, nah, what about it? Let me get in your body system. This body, you are seeing, is not different from God's body. It went in the flesh of chicken. Just traffic and focus it. I believe that God will not plan for you. You are the one that will plan how to carry me there. Not God. When you decide and make your plan, God will now bless your plan. Another factor that affects the pregnancy of a woman is deficiency of vitamin E. Vitamin E, just like vitamin C has the power of building immunity. Vitamin C, if you have vitamin C enough in your body system, it can help you to resist. It builds immunity that can resist any kind of sickness. It can keep you, it can even make you to go quickly. The vitamin E is necessary for conception. Now, number one, are you sure you are not lacking vitamin E? Are you sure you have low vitamin E? Have you taken enough of vitamin E? So what is your problem? What is your vitamin E? How do I get vitamin E? What are the food that I will eat that will give me vitamin E? You don't know anything. So deficiency in vitamin E can affect conception. No matter how healthy you look, you may look very healthy like this, but you lack vitamin E. Go and ask your doctor. Your doctor will tell you if he knows, but some of them don't know anything. For your information, another factor that can affect, maybe you are here now, you are asking for the fruit of the womb, and you are somebody who is very close. You know, one of your friends is alcoholism. You know that. Alcoholism is not good for pregnancy. Please, especially when your case is a special case. Especially when your case is a special case. The moment you know the one half one. Stop taking alcohol. It's not good. Alcoholism affects it. And if you go through your Bible, there's this story about Samson's mother. When God said to Samson's mother, say, don't take any alcohol during this time. And enjoy the drug problem. But the moment you are here now, a large man, you don't know how your body is. You cannot understand where the problem is coming from. Why not plan well? Why not plan well? Now, here you are, some of you here, you drink more alcohol than men. Because that's why you as far as you are concerned, and then drunk. And it shows up in drunk. But it affects the moment you have it, you have, you even when it is easy flow of conception, then you know that you need to be careful of what you take. So let us ask God today to help us. When you have this kind of knowledge, and then your prayer point begin to have focus, then you begin to go. Now, for the men, I will just mention three or four. One is failure in the production of normal spermatozoa. Now, let me quickly let you know this. Why? You see, sometimes you see some men, their sperms are just like water. You know that formerly, we don't know that when we wear pants, and then wear the pants very well, then pack our penis very well, tight it very well, even our laps, and it was affecting the reproductive system of a man. Our testes are not free. And then, like, we heat it up. That is why today, women not they wear panty. Now boss are nigger. Before, we know the one where people see say we get penis. We do something like that, we go back up. We go very well, we don't get panty, we don't open there, come back and put come closer. No, no, see, as we were doing that thing, it is affecting us. And that is it. Today now, no man with normal sense will go and be very bad. And so God will send that again for us. Very few. Now, bosses, when you wear your decal, small decal, and you are free, your body is free. Now, that has affected production. So don't be doing that. But let us now make mathematics. If men want to follow me, we are panicked. When that came, the penis of a man is not free. The testes is not free. That it affects the productive system of a man. What about a woman that does not allow her own body to have fresh air? Who's fashion? I asked one lady one day. I said, can you please tell me why you are always wearing this one? Because she was wearing this skirt and the thing was still showing like neck out to here. I said, why is this? Because I know I grew up in a family of women in those days. And I know that there is this skirt that women used to wear. It is not a skirt, it's very light. Petticoat, yes. Petticoat. Yeah. After wearing pants, they will now wear that thing that look like skirt, but very light and good. For they will now wear this shirt want to wear. And they so then they listen for you know, used to wear that machine where wear. They wear that machine, they will not see our mind. They were like, I say, fuck them. No machine before. Machine has come. And because machine has come, and you now follow, you people have made men to start buying trousers very expensive. You're not jack trousers with us. You are complicating yourself. Let me tell you, if we don't get into my university, they are not taking care of themselves at all. All these things you see me mentioning now, they are scoring 80%, 60%. Because their own time, this teaching we have, is painful. Another reason in a man that can make a man not to be able to pregnant a wife is still infection. There are different kinds of infection. There are different kinds of infection in a man that will make a man not to be able. Gonorrhea, all kinds of diseases. And let me tell you now, there are many of them that we don't know their names. Existing in us, we don't know about them. So when you have such knowledge, you have impotence. You know some men, their body cannot rise. I know of some cases I handled where the husband and wife, they are not finding it easy at all. And many of you may be part of such a man. Before the man's penis can even be strong, it is tough of war. Sometimes you see some women with bitterness. Why? They say, Father, before my husband would just even enter my body, he has released. A lot of complications. It's not easy. It's not why it is so difficult. But let me surprise you. In the midst of all these personal problems that we are having, for some people, they are living bad life, but they are blessed. That day I meet, I have forgot. Only a home at a man and a matter of your home, after that, your home, and did well. He did that for the boss. You know that there are some people that enter their husband's houses as virgins, but eat women. So don't even think that somebody like some of you now, I know why you have to feel. You feel that people will think that you are wayward. Knowledge has proved that it is not because people are. Even there are some wayward people that are overproductive. These are professional shoers. And despite that, they are way. Now the problem is this: all fingers are not equal. I don't know what I am. That is why we need to be careful. We are not careful. We are not careful. Do you know that a prostitute knows how to take care of her sexual life more than body again?
Yes.
No, money?
Yes.
No, you don't know. A prostitute, when you don't get what happened, knows how to take care of her reproductive system. You see her private part that more than 500 men enters in a year. She knows how to take care of it physically. We don't know. We lack knowledge of what we should know. We lack knowledge. We lack knowledge. Knowledge. That is why whenever you see people come here on Wednesday, I try to teach. I try to teach. Some say, Father, you know why I come? I let the Lord. I say, that is it. Complete knowledge. Last minute, I will talk about misunderstanding. That at the end of the year, though, you are with your husband and you are having misunderstanding there. Can I ask you a question? Why is it that within 1 month, you, when they find the king, you and your husband will quarrel 3 times? Are they laughing? Tell me why. You lack woman. You lack no man. Yes, you are tolerating. You don't tolerate at all. And let me tell you now what you don't understand. You are not a woman. A woman whose body is troubled cannot conceive. This one is psychological. You can never catch a fish in a troubled water. Your body is like a river. You can only catch fish in a river that is cool. That is why at night, fishermen will go at night. Because everywhere is so your body is never calm. Iwi we, Amuma, Oisi, Efo we meku, Ewileyi. Even your private part is angry. You did less irritation. You are just angry. You know, people don't know, but you know very well that you are not normal. Your body is tense. You are tense. You are tense. You know very well. But you pretend. Not even money. But you are tense. You wait. Let me tell you, such people, why is it that somebody who lacks this body fat? Not only food, they make us care for you. Oh, a piece of
time.
But many of you are not there. Iwe, and it cannot. Iwe. Oh, one swing. Your body is like a river that they put pipe. All the fish inside are dodge back. Be very careful. Because that is one of the ways that the devil is using to handle us. So, you know, there's what they call the. You know, women have egg.
Yes.
You know, you produce egg.
Yes.
Okay, when you are making love with your husband releases sperm into your body, and then the sperm carries the spermatozoa. The sperm is the vehicle of the spermatozoa. Now, let me explain to you deeper. If you have been privileged to see a maybe a well or a little place where or me or they stopped fetching the water and the water had been there until frog decided to live in that water. If you look at the water, you will see small thing in place. Like over fish or punch, like fish. But it's not fish. It's frog, but baby frog. That is the way spermatozoa looks like. That is the way spermatozoa do. They get head, come get long rope for back like that. So now hear this. One of the reasons why a woman cannot conceive is that when you make love to your husband and he releases the sperm to your body, carry the spermatozoa begin the journey and they cannot reach where your egg is and they die. This is your wedding head day. Don't put it there. Your husband from door, release her. And before you reach there. So even we, now the point is that, what is the way now? This is where God comes in. Apart from any medical treatment you take, this is where God comes in. He said, the hand of Zerubbabel has laid this foundation. This hand must complete it. So, failure of the spermatozoa to reach the female egg, the ovum, on site. Is another reason. So you can see all these things I've mentioned to you since I started speaking. You can see that, that this idea of feeding anyone, not the complex. This is just medical I've been talking about. And then we have some men that have low sperm count. This one is the popular one you talk about. We also have the spiritual reasons. We have talked about the spiritual wives, spiritual husband, whereby you keep on making love in the dream. There's a covenant on your head. That is why you don't joke in prayer. There's a covenant that you entered. There's a covenant that you went into. You are not aware how you entered into that covenant. You don't know how your daughter entered into that covenant. You don't know how your sister entered into that covenant. You don't know how you yourself entered. But I want to let you know, friends in Christ, that in the course of my ministry, I realized that many of us have problems with our foundation. My mother took me to a native doctor and they marked my body. For what? Covenant. Many of us in those days were taken to a river. And the buffers, give the river sweet, give the river biscuit, came in here for a while. That is dedication to them. And that is why, when you marry a husband, every night, I remember the year 2003-04, a particular man, IK is his name, he worked with Union Bank, but he has, he's not a little, the daughter was, they were coming to Issele-uku, they were coming, where they are from. And what is the problem? The problem is that this man, I prayed this man home. Even when the man wanted to build a house like that, I had to give him half a million for my money. Because I love his faith. What was the faith he had? Why he brought the wife? Then, I didn't have a great job, man. Because one morning, man, before God answered him, God is always answering prayer. You will answer your own.
Yeah.
But the major thing why this man brought the wife, which made me love him and made him my spiritual son, was the fact that every night when I came, this man became a prayer. What because of it? We have to capture what? Making love. There we are. Making love. Making love. And then they were saying, wrong, sex. Making love. Shouting and screaming. The one of them looking. That was why the man came to Issele-uku with the wife. Few days ago, they brought out all our old pictures from the store. And I was going to it and I saw the man and the wife when they brought their new baby for Thanksgiving. And I said, I remember Ayinka. There is power. Spiritual realm. You know that the devil has embarked on covenant in so many people that the moment went to me, men, when they see anything red in the dream, blood is coming out. That is the covenant. Let them come. If we make some problem, what is the key that preach at the gate? May they not see any red substance. Where will you see money red? Where will tomatoes? Where will fresh tomatoes? Anything reddish? They have seen their blood immediately. So how do we explain this? Prayer! This is where prayer comes in. So we want to talk about prayer. Even when I was mentioning the medical reasons, this is where prayer comes in. Do you know that there are some women who have embarked into covenant with the fact that their own biological husband irritates them? They say no to sex proposal because of what? The spiritual power that is manipulating them. The spiritual power that is at war. After hearing of such things, your prayer life must change. Amen. You must walk with knowledge. It is not magical. It is when you know all this that you know how to fight. Little prayer works. The spiritual aspect. Other one is the wickedness of man. So I don't know the one that you belong to now. I don't know. But let me tell you one thing now that I also know in the course of my life. Nobody is 100% healthy. You see some of the people that are burning 6, 8, 5, 10, 20. Some of their body, your body better pass their own. Your case may not be that one. Your case may be this spiritual one, or the one I want to mention now. But because you go to the hospital, they still discover that your tube is like, there are some people that their fallopian tube may not be healed, but they can't be. But when we go to the hospital and they discover one thing that bam, injection. There is what called the wickedness of man. The wickedness of man. The wickedness of man. Somebody's desire to be wicked for you, to show you wickedness, or use diabolical power to say you never have your own child. That one also exists. Not only because you have a problem medically. The wickedness of man is also what? I'm giving you the spiritual, I'm giving you the medical, and I'm ending with the social. This social one is the wickedness of fellow brothers and sisters. Some people may have gone to some shrine and have submitted your name and they say you will never have a child. You see? Why do you not join with prayer? How we end on this also? Because we'll be coming again. Keep on asking God very soon. Those who are pregnant will begin to gather. The message I have for pregnant women is well for help. Some of our pregnant mothers are so careless. They don't know that child destiny is in their hands at that point in time. I pray with all my spirit and soul and body, or worthy as I am, that after this mass I celebrate for you, you are conceiving in Jesus' name. Handle all these cases in Jesus' name. Believe. Some resolutions. Number one, please, I beg you, plan your life. Plan your life. Plan your life. Plan how to carry belly. If you see that plan how to carry belly, you're going to say inside a plan, you will say, I don't go quarrel with my husband. That is why it's not good for men. You see, any man when they find picking, any man when they find picking is not permitted in any way to go pour a sperm over any woman body. Because after such program, God don't bless you. Say, okay, in the month of August, I will give you your child. And then in the month of August, you see Phoenicians. You can't go make mistakes, you can't speak to Felicia, come pour your spouse food. Felicia, you see, say, carry the letter. He go wrong, go after them. You see what I say, it's your plan. God can bless you, man. Give. It is not just because it is a sin, but it is a plan. Plan.
Plan your life well. Don't release your strength into a woman that will not value it. Don't. Let the temptation come. Say no. Go to your wife. Because if you imagine how stupid it is when God says, the sperm that will come out from your body in the month of July will be the sperm that will return to your wife. I will send my angels to guide that sperm to achieve this. That is what I will do for you, my son. Or who? Only in the month of August, you see one small, beautiful, good cover. Who went in Kawuko in South Africa? It's a good thing. You now think it is temptation. You think it is temptation. Any temptation. It is denial. It is denial. The devil has planned it. You should have your own plan. Am I talking to someone?
Yeah.
Which particular egg? Which egg is the one that God has blessed? That is why it's not only for a woman and God, not to look out for sleeping anyhow. So let us, with this spirit, know how to pray to God. Know how to talk to God. And know that everything I mentioned here, both medical, both spiritual, both social, that had to do with envy, hatred, wickedness of people, that all these things can be handled by our God. Can be handled by God. And that is why we have come. Please, I want to beg you. Try your best to have covenant day of prayer for fruit of the womb. From Monday to Sunday, bring out a day. You about planning. Plan. Tell God a day like this. I will fast from morning to this. I will not eat so that you will remember me. A day like this, this is what I will do. A day like this, I must do like this. A day like this, I will do like this. You plan it. God likes that kind of plan. When you have done all this plan, God is okay. Let me ask my God. But then you want plan, I can't be my God. You need me to do anyhow. But no. You must have a plan. You must develop a spirituality to win this battle. So I ask God to bless you all. By the grace of God, now we have been every Wednesday. What you with it? What are you doing on Wednesday? Let it be your own spiritual antecedent. Convert it to your own. That's what I know I have it. So every Wednesday, I'm for my spiritual antecedent. I have declared Wednesday to be my own spiritual antecedent. Day after day, that is my spiritual antecedent. I don't care. God likes such programs. And I get that. You don't know. And I want to beg you, don't complicate issues. If your mind tells you, this is my church, whether they go for Okobi Street for prayer, I hear God for blessing. Remain there. Don't come here. Focus on that. Grow. No, it is a spiritual error. I must say, it's not good to church in your church. But beware of spiritism. It is not good. There are some people that cases are very complex because they keep jumping from one prayer house to another prayer house, from one prayer mountain to another prayer mountain, from one prayer. Now you have come here now. I don't know where you are coming from. Yeah, I don't know where you're coming from. And then even as I'm talking to you now, there are some bottles you are leaking, there are some substances you are complicating yourself with, all kinds of advice. I'm not even going to have the doctor. But you must let them be strong. You must build that your own plan. You must have your own plan. You must believe. Persistence least every Wednesday, don't you just enter the church from morning till 12:01. Do it, Lord. I declare Wednesday to be my continental day. Lord, look at me. Extreme me, extreme my miracle, baby. You wait, man. Nobody knows. You let you wait, man. Then you will give your testimony. People will begin to emulate you. I thought the one who said I came and said, John the Baptist. And I said, bring baby boys. And the woman, you man comes here now. Nibble one. Oh, yeah, they were baby beer. This woman, a gel after your window, overhead two baby beers, pink and blue. Overhead in two. Now, during the prayer in St. John, here, many years back, when I asked her to lift it up, I was attracted to what she was lifting up. Why? Because when she lifted it over two, but Eka Kokogi goes out to him and he said that. How? She used needle and stitched the two together. So when she was holding it, she was holding the one edge of pink and one edge of blue. Monem. Maybe next time I'm going to meet, I will call the woman here too, because she used to come. The other day I mentioned her and she was out in the church. She came and was begging me when I'm not the affairs. Oh, my Jibel! Not only a Jibel, I will blue and pink. Surprising. I said, this is the way God works. That is, she planned it. You must plan your work. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
After that, we go on with the mothers.
You to have mercy upon us. In any way we have offended you, in any way we have lived useless life, in any way we have lived careless lives, Father, we are very, very sorry. Let the blood of Jesus wash us clean. Father, wash our lives. Daddy, wash our lives. King of glory, wash our lives. In any way, we have gone to places we are not supposed to go in search of children. We are very sorry. Breaking every curse for barrenness. But like the word says in Galatians chapter 3, verse 13, 14, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, curse everyone that hangs on the tree. If they have laid curse upon you, if they have laid curse upon your life, if they have laid curse upon your children, that they will not have any child, let God arise. Let that curse be broken. Let the power in the blood of Jesus Christ separate you from every ancestral curse. Every curse working against your conception and your pregnancy. Let the power of Jesus begin to work. Let the power of God begin to work. In any way you have been dedicated to any demonic power, bringing our forces. Father Lord, I pray every yoke. I take authority over all associated forces. I cancel the evil consequences of any broken demonic promises, covenant and agreement and education, no prophecy and information. Make sure you are praying. That is why we are better. Because I want us to pray to destroy every satanic deposit. Whatever that is a knot planted by the devil. And that is what is stopping us from becoming fathers and mothers. The Bible says, every plant which my Father in heaven did not plant in your body, in my body, must be pulled out. Now open them up. And I'll put all of them out. Spermatozoa and the egg to work in, I quench that fire. Let the angels of the living God roll away every blockage in your fallopian tubes. In the name of Jesus. Any demonic baby occupying your womb, satanic baby occupying your womb, refusing you to conceive, I cause them to disappear now. I cause them to disappear now. In the name of Jesus. We pray against every power causing miscarriages. We pray against every power causing miscarriages. We pray against every power causing miscarriages. We come against every agent of erectile dysfunctioning. Showing us red objects in the dream. Showing us blood in the dream. Eat every demonic worm. Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost!
pray over your reproductive organs. May God empower all of them. May God empower your reproductive organs. May God empower your reproductive organs. May God empower your reproductive organs. May God empower the reproductive organs of your wife and that of your husband. Receive power. Receive power. Spiritual wife, spiritual husband, spiritual children, wherever they are, I destroy their power. I destroy their powers. 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 In the name of Jesus. Today, I declare your womb open. I declare your family fruitful. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Master Babashinde. Holy Spirit, have your way. Come, Holy Spirit, come, Holy Spirit, come, Holy Spirit. Come and take over now, take over now. Come, Holy Spirit, come, Holy Spirit. Come your fullness, come your fullness. Come your power that is anointing. 1, 2, 3, go! The Holy Ghost is here, the power of God. That is the power of God, that is the anointing of God. All over your body now. Why are you taking that? Take the Holy Ghost. Receive 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 the Holy Ghost. 1, 2, 3, go! That is the power of God. 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 Over your body now. That is anointing. You will receive. That is the power. Thank you. yourself as those prayers.
The Bible says the Spirit of God is coming.
If you believe in the God of Lumen, Christi family, He will do it for you now.
Holy Spirit. Nothing you cannot do. We have received our miracle. Give us the grace to wait for the manifestation. Give us the power to wait for the manifestation. We shall carry our blessings in our hands. We shall stand and testify, oh God, mighty God of Lumen Christi family, do it for us. You can receive Jesus, do it for us. And by faith we have received our miracles. Through the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. No matter how complex, even the ones that have already been closed, open, oh Lord. May this contact with you in this miracle chapel win them their miracles. Father, we are waiting to see them conceive. Father, we shall not die, we shall live. We shall see them come with their children for Thanksgiving. They shall come with their children with Thanksgiving. You shall turn their sorrow to joy. They will do it for you in Jesus' name. I pray for understanding. May you understand God to be the giver of children. May you understand your own plan as you wait for the manifestations of your blessing. Cancel forever every negativity around your life. So shall it be. Bless all you are living of Father and Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Let's give God a clap of praise. Somebody make a joyful noise. Make a joyful noise. Make a joyful noise. The Lord has answered you. You shall celebrate. In Jesus' mighty name. It shall be permanent. It must be permanent. Miraculous child.
Yeah.
Your child will be a child of destiny.
Yeah.
Your this child is coming.
Yeah.
I say this child is coming.
Yeah.
This child is coming.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I pray that the God of fruitfulness will be your God forever.
Yeah.